गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 8 कंपेयरिंग क्वांटिटीज एक्सरसाइज 8.3। इन दिस एक्सरसाइज वी नो हाउ टू फाइंड सिंपल इंटरेस्ट, कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट एंड अमाउंट। सो फॉर्मूला ऑफ सिंपल इंटरेस्ट इज is equal to P into R into T by 100. Okay, where P means principal, R means rate and T means time. Okay, so this is simple interest. You find simple interest P into R into T by 100. Okay, where P is principal, T is time and R is rate. This is here given principal, time and rate. This is question number 1. Part A, okay, but and how can we find compound interest? So formula for compound interest, first we find amount. What is amount? We represent amount for A. This is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power n. In this case, A represent amount, P represent principal, okay, R represent rate, and N represent time. Clear? This is amount. So how you find compound interest? Okay, for compound interest we write compound interest CI. This is compound interest. This is equal to amount minus principal. Okay, this is clear. Another formula to find compound interest is like this, and this is equal to compound interest is P into 1 plus R power by N for this minus 1. Okay, in this formula we can find the compound interest. Clear? So both way, first you find the amount of this formula, after this you subtract principal from amount, then you get compound interest. Or you can use this formula P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N minus 1, where N is represent time, R is represent rate, and the P represent principal. Clear? The first question of this exercise 8.1 is calculate the amount and compound interest on. We find here amount and compound interest. The principal is given here. Principal is 10,800 rupees. Time is 3 years. And the rate is given 2.5. It means that 12 whole 1 by 2. If you convert it, so we obtain here 25/2 percentage. Okay, this is a rate. This is a principal and this is a time. So first we find amount, after this we subtract principal from amount, then we obtain compound interest. Okay, so let's see, this is formula of amount. Okay, here A is equal to, we can write A, this is amount is equal to P into 1 plus r by 100 to the power n. This implies that we put the value of p, r and n, this is given. So here you find amount, is equal to a is equal to p is, this is principal, 10,800 rupees. You write here 10,800 into 1 plus r is rate, r by 100, so r is here rate, so rate is here 12.5, okay, it means then you can write it 25 by 2, so you can write here 25 by 2 into 100 power time n, 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 so n represent time, so time is equal to 3 here, you write here 3. Clear? Now a is equal to 1800 into this is 1 plus here 25 for the 100, okay, 25 for the 100 and 2 for the 8, so you can write here 1 by 8 to the power 3. Clear? Now here 1000, and this implies that amount is equal to 10,800 into here 1 plus 1 by 8. 1 plus 1 by 8 is equal to, you can write 1 plus 1 by 8, this is equal to 8 1 ja 8 plus 1 by 8, this is equal to 9 by 8, okay, so you can write here 9 by 8 power 3, clear, 9 by 8 power 3, this is 9, so you can write it 10,800 into 9 power 3 means 9 into 9 by 8 power 3 means 8 into 8 into 8. This implies that a is equal to 10,800 9 into 9 into 9 9 9 81 9 9 81 into 9, so 9 on the 9, 9 at the 72, so 729 by 8 into 8 into 8, so 8 at the 64 64 at the 8 8 4 the 32 and 8 6 the 48 plus 3, 51. Clear? So you can see here 9 into 9 into 9 is equal to 729 and 8 into 8 into 8 is 512. Then calculate this. First we multiply it and after this divide by, first we multiply 10,800 by 729. After this divide it by 512, and then we obtained 15,377.34. Okay, so this is the amount we find, 15,377.34 rupees, okay, and you can write here this is amount at last. Amount is equal to in rupees 15,377.34. Now we are going to find compound interest. So how can we find compound interest? Subtract a principal from amount. So compound interest is equal to compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. Okay. So here amount is we will find here rupees 15,377.34 minus principal is rupees 10,800. Subtract this. So this is after 3.34 is this clear, 77 also clear, and you subtract it and you got 4,577 rupees. 4,577.34. Clear? You can see here principal is given 10,800 and time is also given 3 years and rate is given 12.5% per annum. Means per year, this is equal to, we can convert it, so we obtain 25/2%, okay, per annum. Okay, now so this is a formula to find amount. A is equal to, A means amount is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. Okay, so here P represent principal, R represent rate, and N represent time. So we put the value of P, R, and N. So we obtain 10,800 into 1 plus 25/2 into 100 to the power 3. Now here you can see 25/100. So 25 on the 25 and 25 for the 100. So here we obtain 4. Into 2, this become 2 4 8, so you write 1/8. 10,800 into 1 plus 1 upon 8 to the power 3, this is equal to 1 plus 1/8, this becomes 1 8 1 8 plus 1 9/8. You can write 9/8 for power 3. Clear? This is 9/8. We can write it 9 into 9 into 9 into 9 3 times by 8 into 8 into 8 and 3 times. Okay, so here we obtain 10,800 into 9 into 9 into 9 by 8 into 8 into 8, because here you can see power is 3. So 9 into 9 into 9, this is equal to 729, and 8 into 8 into 8, this is equal to 512. So in this way, when you multiply 10,000 into 729, after this you divide by 512, then you obtain 15,377.34. This is our required amount, 15,377.34. Now this is our amount. After this we find the compound interest. Formula of compound interest is amount minus principal. So here amount you find 15,377.34 and the principal is given 10,800. So we subtract it and we obtain 4,577.34 rupees. This is a compound interest. Okay, so student, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टूड हाउ टू फाइंड कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट एंड अमाउंट इफ द प्रिंसिपल टाइम एंड रेट आर गिवन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व बी पार्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर ए. दिस इज गिवन द This is a B part of question number one. Here we use P for principal. Principal is given 18,000 rupees. 18,000. Okay. Rate is given. Time for N. This is given 2.5 years. 2.5 years. Okay, and the rate R, we use R. This is a rate. Rate is to given 10% per annum. 10% per annum. Okay, this is given here. So student, you can say this is a principal. We use P for principal and N for time. This is time. This is given 2.5 years. Okay, and this is a rate R. This is a represent rate. 10%. Okay, so first you find, you can write this n, this time is equal to 2 years plus 1/2 year. Okay, clear. So first you find amount for 2 years, after this we find amount for half years. So amount for 2 years is becomes principal amount amount for half years. Okay, so let's see how to solve this question. Now amount for 2 years. Amount for 2 years. Okay, so this represent A is amount. This is equal to P is given 18,000 rupees into 1 plus rate is 10% by 100 and N is 2 years. Okay, so first we find amount for 2 years, after this interest for half years. Okay, so this imply that you can cancel here 10. Okay, so you open here 1/10. Okay, 1 plus 1/10, this is equal to 10 1 ja 10 plus 1 11/10. Okay, this imply that amount is equal to 18,000 into 11/10 power 2, or you can write it amount is equal to 18,000 into 11 into 11 by 10 into 10. So you can cancel 10 after 10. Okay, so in this way you obtain 180 into 11 into 11. So 11 into 11 is equal to 121. 11 into 11 is equal to 121 into 180. Okay, so this is equal to 180 into 11 into 11 is equal to 120. And clear? Now we multiply 180 into 11 into 11. So you can write here 0 first, right? Amount is equal to write 0. Up this 18 in ja 1 ja 18 carry 1, 18 2 ja 36, 36 plus 1 37 carry 3, अगेन 13 18 वन जा 18 18 एंड 3 21 ओके दिस इज योर अमाउंट 21,718 ओके दिस इज अमाउंट फॉर 2 इयर्स आफ्टर दिस वी फाइंड इंटरेस्ट ऑफ हाफ इयर्स ओके नाउ इंटरेस्ट फॉर 1/2 ईयर ऑन रुपीज 21,780 ओके दिस अमाउंट दिस इज अमाउंट फॉर 2 ईयर्स एंड दिस बिकम्स प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नेक्स्ट हाफ ईयर्स ओके सो यू फाइंड सिंपल इंटरेस्ट ऑफ नेक्स्ट हाफ ईयर्स एंड वी टेक दिस इज एज ए प्रिंसिपल क्लियर दिस इज एज ए प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नेक्स्ट हाफ ईयर्स ओके सो फाइंड सिंपल इंटरेस्ट सिंपल इंटरेस्ट इज इक्वल टू वी राइट सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एस आई दिस इज इक्वल टू पी इंटू आर इंटू टी बाई 100 क्लियर नाउ प्रिंसिपल इज गिवेन हियर दिस इज एज ए अमाउंट we take it principal this is the amount we find the amount but after next half years it treat as a principal so we can write here 21,780 and the rate is given here rate is same 10% and time is 1/2 years so we can write here 1/2 and this is equal to by 100 sorry yeah 0 clear 21,780 into 10 into 1/2 this is a principal this is a rate this is time and this is a 100 okay so 2 0 here so 1 0 cancel 1 0 also cancel clear now we obtain here simple interest is equal to 21,700 here up to 2,178 into 1/2 cancel it now 1,089 so in this way you find SI means simple interest is equal to 1,089 clear now going to find total amount after 2.5 years we find the total amount of for 2 years here 21,780 okay and after this we find the simple interest for half years and we take this amount as a principal so you find simple interest is equal to 1,089 okay so if now you find total amount for 2.5 years total amount for 2.5 years is equal to this is our amount 21,780 plus this is 1,089 and this is equal to you can say 22,800 symbol 22,869 8 plus 8 6 clear. This is equal to rupees 22,869. This is a total amount, okay, for 2.5 years. Now you find the compound interest. So compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. Here principal is given 18,000. Here you find amount is equal to rupees 22,869. This is our amount, and now you find compound interest. Compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. This is equal to amount is you find rupees 22,869 minus principal is equal to rupees 18,000. This is equal to subtract this and you find 4,869. Clear? Rupees 4,869. This is our amount. Sorry, this is a required compound interest, and this is our amount 22,869. In these questions, we have given principal 18,000. If principal is given, and rate is 10%. And time is 2.5 years given. Okay, so first we find amount for 2 years. Okay, so amount for 2 years is by using formula P A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100. Clear? And putting in the value R is equal to 10, P is equal to 18,000, and time R is n is 2 years. Okay, because we find the amount for 2 years. So in this way we find the amount for 2 years is 21,780 rupees. Okay, after this we find simple interest for 1/2 years, and we take this amount as a principal. Okay, now so simple interest is equal to, this is simple interest, this is P into R into 3 by 100. Okay, now P is, this principal is, this amount used as a principal for 1/2 years. So this is a amount you find 21,780 into 10, this is R, R means rate, and time is 1 by 2 years by 100. So you can here cancel 10 from here and 0 from here. Okay, so in this way you obtain 2178 into 1 by 2. Okay, so if you cancel 1 by 2, then we obtain 21, and here 16, 8 times and 9 times. So you obtain simple interest is 1089. Okay, so total amount for 2.5 years is equal to 21,780 plus 1089. So in this way you can see, we find the 22,869. This is a total amount for 2.5 years. Okay, 22,869. Now we find the compound interest. For compound interest, the formula is A minus P. Here A is amount and P is principal. Principal is given 18,000 and the amount you find 22,869 rupees. Okay, now, so here 22,869 minus 18,000 rupees. So you have done 4,869 rupees. Okay, so student, I hope all of you understood and familiar the term of the compound interest and the principal, and you can solve it in very easy way. And I hope all of you enjoy this, and thank you for watching. Jai Hind.